Let's consider now the determination of artificial radio strontium in milk. Strontium presence in environmental samples or food is a good indicator of radioactive contamination from a nuclear power plant. Indeed, strontium 90 is an isotope concern in fallout from nuclear accident, but also in monitoring the area surrounding a nuclear power plant, even if not working. Strontium 90 is a bone seeker that exhibits biochemical behavior similar to calcium, the next lighter element in group 2. After entering the organisms, most often by ingestion with contaminated food or water, about 70-80% of it gets excreted. Virtually all remaining strontium 90 is deposited in bones and bone marrow, with the residual 1% remaining in blood and soft tissues. Its presence in bones can cause bone cancer, cancer of nearby tissue and leukemia. Exposure to strontium 90 can be tested by bioassay, most commonly by urinalysis. Recalling the strontium 90 physical properties, it is a beta emitter with a half-life of about 29 years. It undergoes beta decay into yttrium 90 with a decay energy of 546 keV. Yttrium 90 in turn undergoes beta minus decay with a half-life of 64 hours and decay energy of about 2.3 MeV to stable zirconium 90. In order to enable the quantitative measurement of the radionuclide, milk has to be chemically pretreated. A known mass of milk is dried in a oven at 110 Celsius degree until it reaches a constant weight. Then the ashes are burned in a oven at 650 Celsius degree for several hours. The potential strontium 90 present in the sample is leached from the ashes by a mixture of acids. The obtained solution is ready to undergo radiochemical separation. During the chemical separation, not all the analyte can be separated and recovered in the final sample used for the measurement. Some portion of the analyte is lost in the separation process. To find out the proportion of the analyte recovered, the chemical yield has to be measured. The chemical yield is determined with the aid of a stable carrier or a radioactive tracer. In this case, stable strontium is used to monitor the method yield. The separation of strontium 90 from the solution is achieved by extraction chromatography. The sample solution coming from the pretreatment is loaded on a resin column containing chrome ether as the extraction reagent. Strontium is retained by the column, while its decay product yttrium 90 and interferon radionuclides are flushed out from the column. Strontium 90 is eluted with a suitable acid and collected in a safe place in order to wait for yttrium 90 in growth. After 3 weeks, strontium 90 and yttrium 90 reach the secular equilibrium and the activity of yttrium 90 is equal to that of strontium 90. This enables the measurement of strontium 90 by isolating and counting yttrium 90. Secular equilibrium is where the activity of the daughter radionuclide B remains the same as the parent isotope A. After separation, the daughter radionuclide starts to engrowth with its half-life until it reaches activity of parent A, and afterwards it decays with the half-life of the parent A. The sample solution containing strontium and yttrium at equilibrium is loaded on the regenerated column and yttrium 90 is recovered and prepared for LSC counting. The activities of beta-emitting radionuclides can be determined by gas ionization counter, proportional counters, or liquid scintillation counters. In the case of liquid scintillation counting, a scintillation cocktail is added to the sample solution and the vial is measured in a liquid scintillation counter for a sufficient time to achieve the desired counting statistics. Indeed, since the random nature of radioactive decay, it is important to collect a suitable number of events to have a measurement with statistical significance. Furthermore, counting time has to enable to achieve the minimum detectable activity, MDA, that is the level of activity concentration, which is practically achievable by an overall measurement method. The vial is loaded in a counter and after a suitable waiting time, the measurement is acquired. It is necessary to prepare suitable pure strontium-90 and yttrium-90 calibration sources with known activity for determining the LSC detection efficiency. This parameter is defined as the ratio between the counts and the decay events in the time unit. It could be influenced by quenching, a phenomenon that could give interfering counts due to sample color, self-absorption, or chemical properties. To be able to evaluate an activity which can be interpreted as meaning activity, the background count rate due to natural radiation has to be determined by measuring a suitable blank sample. It has the same features of samples in terms of volume, scintillation cutter, and chemical properties. Coming back to minimum detectable activity, it reflects not only the instrument characteristics, such as the background and the efficiency, but also other factors, which influence the measurement, such as the amount of the sample, the chemical yield, and the measuring time. The LSC spectrum of the sample provides the counts attributable to yttrium-90, and by introducing them together with background counts and detection efficiency into the formula, the strontium-90 concentration in the sample is calculated. This would be only a small taste of the type of work radiochemists in the environmental monitoring do.